Okay, welcome back here to RDNMS here for the final round, 12 hours at Le Mans. Give me the garlic, the onions, the snails, everything. Oh, do you remember that snails incident? So, yep, we're back. Yes, Andrew Reid, sorry, every 2 hours in order to save it so that it goes up on YouTube and that you can watch it as much or as little as you like. We have to restart the stream every 2 hours, so it will die down and then come back. Thank you to everyone. For joining us live, we all have the chat box here at racedepartment.com. We also have the forums itself. My name's Simon Smith. I'll be taking and staying with you for the next 12 hours. We've already done nearly two. It's all going rather well. There's the standings on your screen if you're joining us on the YouTube channel, so that you know exactly where you're picking up from where you left off. Not everyone has 12 hours non-stop that they can spare for you all. 42 teams started, 37 still remain. Our five retirements are UKNL on lap 3 with a runtime error. Martin Bulgen and Gary Allen for 1066 Racing had a crash to desktop. Dufresne and Lorraise for ISD GT2 lasted 11 laps before they too had a disconnection. Erdem Akyol for Kenobi lasted to lap 14 before they went down the toilet. And Bence Kozak crashed out at the high speed part of the track for Hell Racing Team Hungary, and it really was hell on earth, lap 21, for an accident. We've just lost Ross McGregor from 22nd place. He's crashed out too. Where has he gone? That car did look like it was having a drama. Let's take a quick look at the... No, the replay's not letting me on it. So, that's a shame. So there's Jan Larsen still leading the way. But yeah, Ross McGregor, that car did look a little bit dodgy beforehand. It's going to look even worse now. What else is going on? That would be me. Okay. There we are. We're back live now with Jan Larsen. Let me just pop the order on your screens. But that's unfortunate there. Larsen leading from Berlacher, Kassa, Enders, Szczeski still lapped. Someone is tapping me, but unfortunately... Ah! Ah! Now, the problem is I have been... Well, I have been joined by one of the Chuckle Brothers, but he can't introduce himself because that won't work. So, there's someone in the broadcast booth and I can smell something cooking. It's Joachim Skalstad! Woo! How you doing, my friend?
I would say I'm doing good, but I'm not.
Oh no!
I had almost none sleep tonight, and I'm also getting quite sick in the throat.
Oh.
So.
Oh no! Well,
but this could be interesting.
It could be interesting. You're sounding a bit laggy as well, actually. I don't know if that's just me, but...
Yeah, that might be the computer.
Ah, it's computer not feeling well either.
To log in.
Oh, no. Well, it's a pleasure to have you with us. If you don't feel grand, then just sit back and relax with a Lemsip. Bram Hengeveld is sending you a fruit basket.
Oh.
Ah. Feel the love. I'm sending you a collection of tablets.
Oh yeah, that's great.
Not those kind of tablets, Joachim.
Not the blue ones.
Not the blue ones.
Oh.
don't pick the blue pill.
Oh no.
But never mind, never mind. So, let's just see what's going on. Quick recap for everyone that's just joining us, including Joachim. I don't know if you've been watching at all. But,
no, I've been watching.
Oh, have you?
Yeah.
Awesomeosaurus.
It's just my computer is rubbish, so I can't log into TeamSpeak. So.
Oh, bless. But no, it's all been going rather wild out on track. And talking of wild, welcome to the race taking over the SRH Zenno M car, Remco de Wild, for the P2 category. Of course, your fellow chuckle brother, Roy Magnus, is out on track at the moment, isn't he?
Yeah, I know. I'm sitting in it.
How's he doing? How's he doing? Can he shout at the camera?
Well, he has made a couple of small spins. But he's driving. Yeah. And he is in his second stint for this
race.
for a driver swap in about an hour or so. What is this going on? And we'll see. Maybe if they need me, I'll be driving later.
Okay. Well, I look forward to seeing what fun you bring up.
Yeah. Me too. I haven't tested
and what? Oh, God. So, you may be bringing up quite a lot, especially if you are that ill. Best battle out on track then is for 27th and 28th positions. Let's jump to that. It's Robin Toll for Rare Endurance, third position in the GT2 class, with Marcel Persch just 1.4 seconds behind. This is the closest battle because Peter Enders has got round Petter Kazza off our screens and has pulled away 4 seconds. So while he closes down on Vladislav Bialecka, we'll wait for those two to catch up. But yep, then. Toll on Persch, sorry, fourth in the GT2 class, forgot who Terp was up there. All going quite well. Excuse me. I think we're all a bit ill at the moment. It's that time of year.
Might be.
Might be. Either that or.
Good until last night.
There's a lot of cookie stealing going on in the chat room.
Yeah.
Thank you very much, everyone, for joining in, actually, on the chat itself. So, what's your opinion of the Le Mans circuit? Do you like it?
Fast, tricky or somewhere. You really, before you just go flat out there. Everywhere. And all. Just going for 300 kilometers an hour for a long time.
Well, I caught bits of that. You're really, really choppy, so
yeah.
Apologies if this is going through on the broadcast. It might just be me as well, because I'm having a thick day. Curly Whirly. Dave Simmons said Curly Whirly. Yum yums. Are they still going, Curly Whirlies? Well, in fact, that actually now starts off today's topic of the day. What is everyone's favourite chocolate sweetie? Because I've been... In Asda, I don't know if you have an Asda where you are in the Nordic part of the world, but it's the supermarket thing in the middle. Ah, cool. They've been doing 5 miles per pound, and I have seriously at least gone up one bra size since they've come out. So I've been very fat. So everyone needs their favourite thing. Dave Kid Carter says Fry's Turkish Delight. They're so expensive. They are nice. But yeah, everyone can come in and tell us that. Of course, if you've driven, you can pop in and chat to us as well. God needs friends. So we should do that. And of course, we've got the chat room, we've got the forum, we've got live timing. Hell, we've got everything in the world going on here as Robin Toll continues to cling on to fourth overall in the championship. Someone's just changed position. That it's Gregory De Greef and Joseph Mudrack, the 13th and 14th positions. We'll cut to it in a second, because that looks as though Persch and Toll are going at each other. Or is it? No, it's they're slapping Curlin Belinde, so those two struggling. Joseph Mudrack though has got round Gregory De Greef. And there they are. Oh, is that Mudrack? They're missing quite a lot of car. Oh dearie me, that's not worked out well at all. Let's see if a replay is available. Probably not, because it does like a little bit of lagaroo. No. Nothing with that at all. So, that's a shame. Now I'm assuming that that came to blows with De Greef, because that is a hell of a lot of car missing. And I don't think that will pop along. just getting a couple of driver interviews sorted and lined up. We've got, from the back of the grid itself, it is Optimum Racing's Jonathan Aisselinth. Your teammate Jonathan Motteram has just taken over the wheel. How did it go for you, John? Because you was in a lot of trouble.
It was quite an interesting stint with... I did a few mistakes, one at Indianapolis where I hit the wall quite hard.
Yeah. But
otherwise it was quite nice. Didn't.
Awesome stuff. Obviously the big one was where you spun back onto the racing track in front of Ballage Kiss and got yourself a drive-through penalty. Explain that a little bit for us.
I got the drive-through penalty for that.
Yeah.
I'm not sure where was it.
I don't know where it was. This track's far too big. But yeah, it was. You just spun across the track and you got a drive-through penalty. So obviously not good.
It was at Indianapolis, I believe, where you were off the track, and then when you rejoined, you did a.
Yeah, it was the same situation where I hit the wall. Yeah. Yeah, I spanned the tires a bit too much and I spun in front of him, unfortunately.
Okay, not to worry, not to worry. But your car's still going at the moment, are you just aiming for a finish today?
Yeah, that will probably be what we are going for.
Good stuff. Peter Enns has just lost third position, lovely. Well, best of luck and... we hope you do make it to the end, and we'll come in along and chat to you soon. We're just going to go to the battle for third and fourth, because Peter Enders has dropped back behind Petter Kazza in this yo-yo battle for third overall in the P1 class. They've just gone round Gregory De Greef to lap them, and they're speeding side by side down the straight, and it's anyone's guess who's going to make it for the corner. Enders is going around the outside to try and get back for Kazza. Kazza gives him enough room, and he's just about kept it on. There was rubbing between the two. But Kazza did not get the position. Enders clings on to third position. These two now half a minute behind Jan Larsson, and Vladislav Berlacher continues to stay 11 seconds ahead of them. But as these two continue to battle, they'll only fall away from those leading duo, and Berlacher for Akuri SI Motorsports is just having a giggle up in second place because he's sneaked in there just by being quietly quick. But Kazza versus Enders, once again Atlantic versus Torrent Motorsports. They do seem to be yo-yoing about, and it's been absolutely fascinating to watch. Just half a second between them at the moment. More traffic up ahead. It's Roy Magnus, your chuckle brother.
Yeah.
Tried to tell him not to get involved in this one.
I'll reach over for you.
Okay. give it a friendly yank.
Yeah.
Make sure it's the wheel grab.
Oh yeah.
That would be bad.
Oh, well, I think these two just passed Roy.
Yeah.
They did indeed. They continue on their skirmish over third position. Atlantic versus TMO. Still a couple of good battles going on, but this is the closest one at the moment that we've got out on track. Robin Toll is still ahead of Marcel Persch. The gap between that has extended to a couple of seconds now, so he's actually starting to pull away. Welcome to the race in 20th position, Alvin Wavers for Blue Water Racing. We'll get a view of him later on. But I want to see what Kazza does with Enders, because he is sizing him up for size down to turn two. So down the hill they go, and he's pushing out to the left-hand side, but Enders covers the line nicely for what is the first braking opportunity on this lap. But alone we've got the epic long straights. Let's see what they can pull off here. Jaunty camera angle. You can see looking back on Kazza.
Yep, the contact that they had on the previous lap won't have benefited either of them. That would have lost definitely Petter if he bit at top speed, but it looks like in the draft he should be alright. But yeah, you want to avoid any yellow damage on this as Enders goes defensive.
Ooh!
It starts to move back over.
Oh. Okay. Thank you, Dennis. For your information, it's pronounced Sim Motorsport, not Arse Eye Motorsport. I don't think I've said Arse Eye. I may have said some other stuff, but
well,
here comes.
It's difficult because it's SI Motorsport if you're looking at the spelling, but maybe they're using the M twice, so and once again, these two are going side by side and rubbing. They've got to stop doing that into this corner. They're just going to give each other more and more yellow damage.
Oh, yes.
Although, where has Petr Kasa gone? Well, there, he lost a little bit of time with that. They compromised on the exit. Sorry, Dennis, about that. We will call it Sim Motorsport from now on.
I'd be a bit worried if my arse had an eye on it. Bad enough having eyes at the back of my head as they go round Kyle Middleton. In fact, I was a bit worried that when I was English, people kept saying that I had a Jap sign. But that's another story for another day. So, actually, on that lap, scarily enough, they closed in on Jan Larsen on the lead by just over half a second. But Kasa there has dropped away as they've gone round Cohen Velinde as well. So traffic not working out for Kasa. Been such a strange battle because they've been kind of, it's like an elastic band. They get to about 6 or 7 seconds apart, and then all of a sudden they're all over each other, and then they go, oh no, couldn't quite possibly pass, and then it goes back up again to a few seconds, and it just, it's like Vanessa Feltz's waistline. It's just constantly back and forth, up and down, never quite going away. Who was that looking a little bit dodgy there? Oh, it's Hodgewedge versus Room for 9th and 10th position, side by side. And Reino Room is going up the inside of Hodgewedge. Hodgewedge there completely missing the braking opportunity for the corner and lets Room through. Stops down to 10th, so GTA may go after his illegal pass. Up to 9th position now in the P1 cast. Next up is Stefan Persson for Atlantic Racing Team. Not too far up the road, actually, to be honest. So that'll be interesting to see. And those two, a lap down from the leaders at the moment. The entire field covered by 8 laps. Jonathan Mottram for Opium is still... Opium? Oh, Motorsports. My God, that would explain their driving. Optimum Motorsports will be up into 36 once he's passed the stricken Ross McGregor, who, of course, binned it earlier on. Welcome to the race, Simon Melhuish, my cameraman extraordinaire. In 30th position. Good to see you actually behind the wheel for once, mate, because you are my long-suffering cameraman for far too many rounds, and you must be itching and scratching to actually get back behind the cockpit. They don't call it the cockpit for nothing, honey. So, good to see him out there. Don't crash! We talked about this. Okay, so I'm going to grab a quick drink. If you're back from tea break, I shall be a minute and a half tops.
Hello, Joachim. Where have you been today?
Sleeping.
Sleeping?
With his missus.
Yeah. Oh, no. Don't you watch Fix Simon? No, last night around 11. I called for a friend of mine who was out driving in the forest roads, and he went off the road. Wondered if I can come and help him. Around 5 o'clock this morning, I went home. So
okay.
So far off the road, yeah.
Okay, well, at least you have a valid excuse.
Yeah.
Alvin Nieves has had an incident. Let's see if we can get a replay of this. He's sitting in the middle of the track, and let's fast forward. I don't know if we're going to get anything or not. No, it's lag, but he's obviously gone off.
Yeah, left track.
Oh, so they've DNF'd. They've killed the engine then.
Looked like they crashed the car quite hard there.
Yes. So, Waterblue Racing P2 car with 20th overall and now out of the race. We have passed the 10-hour mark to go, so we'd be racing for 2 hours and 4 minutes. Quite a bit of action so far going on. We are down to 35 runners. We've had 1, 2, 3, 4. No, my lifetime just updated. We've had 7 DNFs so far, which is not too bad. It's always, you always hope for less than you actually have. Yeah, let's hope we can get the number, a decent number to the flag. I know it's 12 hours, so it is the biggest challenge, longest race on the calendar. Yeah, if we can get around 20, at least 20 to the flag, that would be a good achievement.
Likely to, thinking.
How much the DNF so far hasn't computer related?
I'm not entirely sure, actually. Ricardo Acevedo has hit something. I got the lifetime in telling me he's had a bit of damage. I don't think the replay will pick it up, but...
Of course he is, it's Thames International.
I think that gap was saying it was over 10 seconds before between the person behind and now it's 5, so he's had an issue somewhere. The downforce Ferrari GT2 in front still driving around without a split. I believe that's Jell Vogels, I believe.
Ooh! Well, he couldn't possibly be driving a car in one piece. Although, he's in 30 seconds, so that's actually gone quite well for him. Oh, well, and the Wavis is out, is it? Has we covered that?
Yeah, they in sector 3, I think, going up to the Porsche kerbs. It looked like they had a big crash and he didn't attempt to get back to the pits.
He's only been in the car for 10 minutes! I don't think his teammates will be particularly excitable.
Happy.
Oh, as Enders and Kassa are at it again, side by side.
Yep, so Kassa's caught him because that went down to 3 seconds. But now it's back to, as you can see, literally inches. I wonder if Kassa will force the move here. We've seen a bit of contact between these two so far in the last 10 to 15 minutes. So, we hope for a clean move, but they're coming up to the most difficult sector now on the track, sector 3 with the Porsche kerbs. He's an awesome camera angle here. Not a safe place to pass, so he'll need to stay as close as he can to this sector, go across the start-finish line, get in the tow, and he should be able to get him on the Miles Hand straight.
Not quite the M25, is it, rather, as I go round?
It's too clear.
I know, Dave Carr-Smith, BNB will be back, although optimum rating is proving to be my entertainment for the afternoon, so that should be good. As across the chicane they go, look at how Kassa is able to almost straight line that chicane as they go across the line. What's the gap as they go across? 0.8 seconds, so still looking good. As they come through, who they got? That's Dehan there. They're just getting round, who's also needs welcoming to the race because he is new. I can't even see him on my list.
He's normally driving the SSBN number 2 car, so I think he's taken
33rd.
Tinnemann Boss.
Yeah. Good call. So, but by doing that, that's actually dropped Kassa a little bit behind, and they've got Mosherum there just coming up as well, so. Bunch of clowns, new team idea now, yeah. That seems to have thinned itself out slightly, but I'm sure it won't be too long before they're back together.
Oh, it didn't look like he was compromised by that SRVN GT2 Ferrari. It doesn't look like he is close enough to be in the slipstream as they go past the Thames International P2 car. So Kassa has dropped back. I wonder if this is also to do with the damage that he got from the contact these two had a couple of laps ago.
We shall see. They are closing down Vladislav Berlacher though. The gap between them is now 6 seconds. It was 11. So that's going quite nicely. They're actually also closing down on overall on the leader, who is Jan Larsen, as that's Joseph Mudrack in the pits for a long stop. But they were over half a minute behind. They're now 27 seconds behind. So slowly but surely, but they've got 10 hours to close it in. So Jan Larsen being caught. Andreas Loffler for the Black Rebels has taken over Grigory De Greef as well for 14th position. So that's all good. Welcome to the race, Andreas. And also, Ruri Nascimento has taken over the Thames International car in 15th place. So a few new names popping in at the 2 hour mark. That's all looking good. And Loffler there, is that him out just ahead of Mudrat?
Yep.
Yes, he is, he's through.
Made the pass, yeah.
So Loffler wasting no time at all.
He will come under attack from Joseph as they go onto the Mulsanne Street, I would guess. As he's so close behind. That's not the best rear camera view.
No!
the rear wing just blocks it. It's not like on the other cars. So just you can get another one.
Loving that tarmac.
That's not good either.
They are just passing. That would be Carl Middleton, isn't it?
Total Sim Racing.
It is. Carl Middleton.
And the LSD car, they're running a new livery today. Again, with the R car theme. So quite a nice degree sounding. We are not seeing the other LSD car, which is in the same livery but in blue. They had some sort of issue early on. It looks like Mudrak is definitely closed up. You can't really get a better shot of it.
No, still, he's not poking out from the slipstream as I can see on the shots, and he's gone right to the back. He's hit the rear of Loffler, whatever his name is, Lifeloff. But Mudrak there just locked up his brakes and went smack into the back of him, and that actually means that he's now more than a second behind, so that's worked out doubly bad for him because he won't be close enough in the slipstream down this straight. Quick birthday shout out to Brandon Warren, by the way. Happy birthday, mate. Hope today's race brings you a good result for the World Connect competition. Where are you all, actually? You're down in 25th. With Marcel Persch, fourth overall in the GT2 class. So that's working out well for you. Okay. Is Kassa and Enders side by side again? And Kassa's through. Kassa's through in third position. Or are they? Because now Enders is trying to go back round the outside as they go over the bumpy trot hill. It's all going to be who breaks latest, and Kassa this time is through. Has he gone in too deep? Because Enders is doing a switcheroo, and Enders comes back across. Kassa tries desperately to cling onto the line. Can't do it. Needs to just get back in the slipstream, and Kassa straight crawling under the rear wing. You can just see him in the corner left-hand side of the screen like a little Satsuma. Mr. Fritter himself, but he's pulling out of that racing line a bit too quick. They've got Brendan Kaczmarek just up ahead, leader of the P2 class for R4R. Off in the barriers, is that? For Brendan, that's not worked out at all well for Brendan, leading the P2 class. Oh dear.
I think he kept it out of all those.
Oh good, 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 good. I couldn't tell by my camera angle there. It just looked like he was off into oblivion. So good stuff for Brendan if he's kept out of the barrier there. And here comes Kassa.
A little bit laggy, Joachim.
Yeah, I know. it looks like Brendan is missing the front bit.
Oh, maybe he did hit wall then. If, get him up, number 10 overall. Yeah, definitely missing something, so, sorry, we missed that.
Not to worry, not to worry. Back to the B-B-Door battle. I'll keep my beady eye on what he's up to for the last double chicanes. And that time, actually, it looks as though, as they pass Jonathan Dion there, who's just parked up in the pits, and Steve Davis there just rejoining the track just in the corner of the cameras as well. Welcome to the race, Steve, for 05.
At 25.
25.
And over from
45, 65.
Jeffrey Ruskus.
But yeah, so good old Rusk is out. Obviously the babies chewed him up. And onwards we go. But Cassidy once again has dropped off and behind, so it's going to be a bit of a recovery for him over the next couple of straights before he can attack back again. So, at risk of spending the entire race at this P3, P4 battle. Let's have a quick look at 24th place.
For a second, I thought we'd lost the stream PC there, but now it's a little bit of lag.
Doing good.
My PC.
No. So there is Steve Davis in 24th position. Welcome to the race. Who else did I see there pop on to? We've not seen Jill Dehan in 32nd either. Let's give him a quick how's your father. And who else have we listed? Oh, Jean-Marie Miro is in as well in 6th place for Team RC. So that's all good. Now you can see the racing positions on your screen as you're watching Peter Enders. There's your last lap buys, so Enders there by far the fastest in the 307s, everyone else trailing behind. You can really see it is a four-car race, really, for this win currently.
Let's see, it's just driven through a front splitter that was left on the track. Who's that going slowly? Is that 19? I believe Scott Bennett, the SRS team. Let's see if we can get a replay of that. I don't think we will. Oh, looks like we will.
Oh! Bish bash bosh. That was a bit clumsy.
So he's lost it then. He's come to the kink of Indianapolis, applied the brakes a little bit too early. And that was the splitter that was left on the track that Peter Enders drove through, so it's going to be some quite heavy damage there for the SRS guys.
Back to the pits, I'd imagine, unless you, well, I suppose you can continue on without a front splitter.
It's not advised in a prototype.
No. Not around so, because it's one of these tracks where everything is such a fast corner, you need your car to be all in one piece. You don't want pieces of Lego missing off it, so obviously that will cause problems time over fist. Also, welcome to the race down in 29th position, Tony Carl Christensen for Atlantic Team GT2. So, a few people now.
He's got the Sim Motorsport GT2 team right behind him. But Porsche 99 and GT2 cars.
Just a
also
quick.
Got the race leader, I think, going up inside of them.
Must be a bit uncomfortable.
SRS car that's not pitted, it's chosen to stay out without a front splitter. If we look at how close Roma Lubicic gets. The braking, surely he should be, he's dropped a little bit now, but if he stays in the tow, he should be alright. Looks like there's prototypes coming up behind him as well.
It's Reino Room, Kashmerik as well. Probably catch them quite quickly. Absolutely nuts driving for these, and through goes Reino. I think the room was made for him. Kashmerik will dive through as well on Lubicic. I suppose because they go through so quickly, there's no point trying to cap the toe off them because they're gone as soon as they're passed.
You get a small toe with the P2s, if they're slightly damaged, you can stick with them a bit for the P1s, so they just disappear really. Yeah, definitely that's in Motorsport. GT2 car looks like it's very slow down the straight because the Atlantic car has just disappeared.
Yeah. In fact, Lubicic, they're a good 2 seconds or so now further behind down that straight, so maybe quicker around the corners, different setups, obviously, but not quite working out, because under braking, all of a sudden, it's back to being a lot closer, so... Excuse me, different people trying different strategies. Simon Melewish not too far up the road either, actually, for Total Sim Racing. So, a quick view on a couple of the other drivers then that have joined. Sixth place, Miro, there for Team Arcia. As we've got a few cheerers on in the chat room, we'll show him very quickly for a couple of seconds. We've seen Steve Davis, haven't we? And who was the other one that I was going to bring up? No, it was just Gilles Jahan, who I know joined earlier on, but we've not actually seen him in 32nd position. So let's just bring him on very, very quickly. But sim racing.
Oh, just caught the mess up, yeah.
Yeah, easier done. That still 35 teams going. This is going quite nicely indeed. And Peter Enders is up to second because our leader is in the pits, in fourth position. Yeah, Larson. And so, for the first time this race, Akuri Sim Motorsport is in at the. Berlacher. Oh, sorry, in the lead, sorry. Vladislav Berlacher has the P1 next to his name. Good stuff.
So, will we see
Rainer Rums out.
P1s. Ooh, what's happened there?
GT Omega DNF on lap 41. Now down to 11th, but showing as Ballage Kiss moves past. But not quite sure. I'd assume that's a disconnection, although Rainer Rum has a crashable reputation sometimes in his lesser better days. Excellent speed, but not always barrier friendly. So do you guys actually have a preference of which type of cars you like to race? P1s, P2s, GT2s?
Touring cars.
Not really sure that was a choice, but yeah.
just like to bash up cars, don't you, really?
For me, it's really GT2. I can't drive cars with lots of downforce. So yeah, I tend to stick in GT2 class.
Okay. I have to prefer whatever I'm driving, so. Not sure. Is it P2?
Yep.
It's ready? Yeah.
P2.
You're not sure which car you're driving, Yogi.
Okay, I have absolutely no reference to the LMS series before I started coming.
Okay. This could be an interestingly short stint for Yogi when he's out on track.
It might be.
Aww, never mind.
Looks like there's been a driver swap. Robin de Jong, has he taken over, or was he driving before?
No, he's just taken over from Rupert Hoogtep for SRV and GT. Third overall in their category, out just in ahead of Marcel Persch. Those
who have just been passed close by the 25 motorsport car, believe. Oh no, I'm completely wrong. Ignore that.
No, Steve Davis. Well, up ahead.
Yep, it was just the other SRVN car. I don't think that they're a lap behind, so.
Whenever I see Steve Davis's name, I do think of the snooker player.
Well, not he's a lookalike. You should see Steve Davis. Type him in on Facebook. You see lots and lots of pictures. Actually, no, you won't see anything. He didn't even accept my friend request. So. Yeah, it's not even a picture.
So. Well, I feel we could do like a RDLMS version of Tick Me Out. Let the Brussels see the sprout or something. And we could have a mates get together as Berlacher's in from the lead and has dropped down to third position. Enders leads from Casa now for Atlantic Torrent Motorsport Akuri. Tim Brook is in an overtaken over 05 motorsports car. So, welcome to the race, Tim Brook, in fourth position. And he goes past Berlacher too. So, Tim Brook, the first of our leading quattro to have a driver change 05 Motorsports. And we all know Tim Brooks fast and speedy. Berlacher stays in the car for Akuri and rejoins in fourth. But actually, that has really not played to anywhere his advantage at all. He's gone from second to fourth after a long 44-second stop. So that must have been for tyres.
The top two yet to pit, I believe. So Peter Enders and Petter Kasser, I think they'll be coming in this lap.
Still very, very close. They've got Neil Tasker in between them at the moment for the lead as they lap the GT2 driver for Walter Blue, isn't it? So, Enders taking a wide line in. Kasser just keeping a watching brief, not really attacking at the moment. As Dave Carr Smith in the chat room has pointed out, consistency over speed, always the way to go on the LMS series here, or in endurance racing in general. I prefer to go to consistency over speed, it's just that I've gone far too consistent and just no speed whatsoever. The last time that I was racing competitively in sim racing, before I got my new computer, and I really need to get back into sim racing and actually driving.
Roy went to the wall, Roy.
Ooh. The 20th overall got my timing telling me he's damaged.
Yeah.
It's a very dangerous spot. Let's see if we can get a relay.
Stuck on the curve.
Oh dear, Roy.
If he's managed to get out of it. I think he has.
There.
Oh, he's off. Hopefully no one hits him. Missing a rear wing. I think he's missing the front wing as well.
I think he hit me in the back. He's from the car. Or out the wall, the back first. When he's going into the pit, something going to make Ryos off as well.
Yeah. Hopefully you can make it back safely. We've got traffic coming up there.
Yeah, it's on the front bit.
That's some quite intense typing going on there. If that was typing.
Please. What else would you think I would be doing? I don't know. It was just my finger trying to get even deeper in the moose cups. Try and get more of them. I tell you what. Here's a whole new definition.
Doesn't really understand what's going on. Simon has really been enjoying moose today, and before the broadcast started, I had a running commentary of Simon scraping every last gram of moose out of the pot. I was afraid he was actually going to climb into the pot and lick it out.
I like to give a new definition to the word sticky fingers.
Oh,
as Roy Magnus pops into the pit lane to replace himself. I hope that wasn't because we were being rude that he binned that car.
He's
dropping in. Or is he just generally cack? Okay, I'll do. We love you, Roy. Keep going. I'm pregnant with your baby. Well, we've been joined in the chat room by not one drivers, but two at the same time. It's almost like a bacake. So, or bacaki, whatever it's pronounced. I don't know, you just see it on XTube. We have...
Sorry, I've just realised what you just said. That is extremely over the line. That is a new record. 21 watching that picked up on that word, don't type it into Google or don't type it in on XTube, otherwise
no.
Seeing what Simon sees for 4 hours every night.
4 hours every night. That is an endurance race onto its own, that is. I tell you what you can type into Google, do a barrel roll.
Yeah,
and then
that's fun.
That does make me giggle. But we have been joined by... I'm trying to recover it now. Ryan Walker, the man who's a wrong one in a sporran, and Mr. Weed himself, Wayne Weed, who, I'm sorry mate, but you are... Ooh, is that Kazarin?
Yeah, I'm not quite sure how this has happened because...
We might have to put you in a hole, it's 2 seconds.
I'm not sure if Petter pitted and did a shorter stop, but Tim should have been Petter well
pitted.
Ahead.
Petter pitted, picture pipe pepper phones.
So,
no, he hasn't, by the way.
He hasn't, no? So maybe
no.
There was a... Actually, no, Peter Enders has pitted because he's now 20 seconds back. But before the pit stops, Peter Enders was 30 seconds behind the 05 car. So I don't know if something's happened to him or...
Maybe because of the driver swap, then maybe it was a little bit longer,
actually,
maybe,
that
or something.
Been about the 10 seconds, yeah. So. Yep, sorry. Back to you then. I'll leave it on this camera, though.
Okay, we'll keep a BDI because although they are battling on track, it's not effectively for position at the moment, although Casa is getting quite fierce in his banana fritter. So, Ryan, you've been out on track, having a good old giggle with it. How was it for you?
Yeah, it was brilliant, brilliant fun. Absolutely enjoyed it.
Oh, Brooks in! Sorry to
and
cut across.
And Casa spun as well.
Doing the old spinning round, that's the worst part of the circuit to have it on. Neil Tasker and Kazmarek are going to miss him just about, but Casa getting in second position, I think reacting to the fact that Brooke had run off ride and was like, no, he's going to come. But Brooke actually kept his footing and somehow kept it out from being a catastrophe. Casa, there, I think I'd have done the same to try and not crash into him, but... What a shame there, because that's put a bottle cork on that. Sorry to cut across you there, Ryan, but...
That's also not a good start for Tim Brooke, because he's now going to have to drive the rest of his stint with yellow damage. After that was quite a hefty hit on the wall, so he's going to lose a lot of top speed.
Damn it. So, changing the dynamic of the race already, 2.5 hours in. So yeah, he was enjoying it then, Ryan.
Yeah, good fun.
Cool. And then, so, what are you thinking for the rest of the race? Just get to the finish like normal, or...?
The race is just get to the finish, get to the end of my stints, and hand the car over to Simon for his stints without any damage, and just make it to the end of the race.
I'm not driving! Was it Milovic, sorry, yeah.
Yeah.
I was getting very confused there. Oh, cool. Well, are you back in the car later on, then?
I should be back in the car about 4 o'clock or 4:30.
Well, I think that means a pre-jitter nerves beer beforehand to keep yourself in good shape. And of course, we've... So, Alki. And then we've got Wayne Reid, obviously, in here at all. You was having some right good battles going on.
Oh, I'd have to say it's... For me, it's been the best experience of the scene. But generally, in the spike, it's normally cars coming past you to lap you. I can't think who it was now. It'd be on me for about 8 laps. I wish they'd have just gone away somewhere. Very sweaty palms. Feel my heart, my head at stages.
Yeah,
Looking good.
It is at the moment, and you're just bouncing around the top 20. Just on your screens at the moment is Matt Strand and Marcel Persch battling for fourth overall in the GT2 class. Persch has been attacked left, right and centre all race, but now he's doing the attacking now, fencing the go at Strand at the end of this straight, but he's pulled back in for a second bite of the slipstream before he has another go. And of course you've had lots of experience of this type of battle throughout your stint, Wayne, so do you have any particular tips on how to... Do you find getting like second bites of the slipstream and stuff helped you along or anything like that?
Yeah, that and trying your best to try and outbrake them. I don't know, it's kind of a guessing game more than anything, but you tend to find some of them, the ones that are running the lower wings, are braking a bit earlier, which gives you a bit of advantage, because we're seriously down on straight line speed. I underestimated my setup with that one. But then we're picking it up again in the corners, so it's a bit of give and take, really.
Okay. And what do you have any particular aims or targets for this race at all?
Finish this one, definitely. I mean, we've done, I think it was 10.5 hours last year, and I bent it into a wall, knocked 2 wheels off, as you probably remember. And
I do remember that.
To the pit lane with no front wheels, and then the engine blew up just as I got to the pit lane. A lot of nemesis track for me, this one.
I do remember that, actually. Are you going back out in the car again, then?
Yeah, about 6 o'clock I should be doing another stint.
Okay, so not right at the end?
No, I'm hoping to avoid it if I can. I don't like doing the end, because you get that feeling that something's going to go pear-shaped with about 15 minutes left.
think positive.
Oh, I don't think positive. I'm English.
You're voicing your big wish.
Yeah, definitely. But no, while I'm in here as well, just want to obviously thank George for the season medal. I mean, there's obviously many people have probably seen when the league was announced, me and George didn't get off to the best of starts.
Fight!
I seem to remember quite a good stage of bickering going on in there, and PMs and whatnot, but I will have to hold my hands up and say that without a doubt it's been the best Le Mans series by a long shot, and I was quite gutted the other day when he announced that he was taking a back seat, so it has been fantastic, and your work's definitely paid off. So I know through me and all the people that drive with me, we've had an absolute blast this season. So just to wish you all the best, and thanks very much.
Thank you very much. Get into emotional now, TeamSpeak.
Yeah.
Group hugs, everyone.
You have to start with us lot for what, 5 months of the year? I think you have to have some kind of reward. But yeah, we got to get Simon in the car. I think he deserves. I think we should have a 5 minute thingy race. We'll get Simon out there. I don't know, a parade race where we all drive around really slow.
Last time I drove with you on track, Rain. I can't say it. It's all Jonathan Ross. What's going on? Last time I drove with you would have been Adelaide, FSR. I know, harsh letters. Always, here comes Marcel by the looks of it. On Matt Strand, is he going to have a go? Oh, he doesn't need to wait. He's going to have a quick sniff up the inside before we get anywhere, by the looks of it. Or is he topped out? Yeah, yes, because look at the way he's pulling away.
He got some damage earlier, so the Porsche is quicker than the Ferrari in a straight line, but the aero damage means that as soon as he falls out of the toe, he can't get past.
That is like the ultimate big thing. Not even funny. But yeah, so last time that we drove together would have been Adelaide FSR winter season 08, because I was driving with the arrow keys on the keyboard.
Yes.
And I remember that very well.
I've seen the videos.
You were driving in FSR with arrow keys.
Yes, I've seen.
Yeah?
You want to see the video? I don't know. You know the jerky videos you see when someone robbed a bank? That's what you get watching him round Adelaide on the keyboard.
But quite hilariously, while everyone else crashed out, I finished 7th.
Well, you did well.
But I think you was one of the other finishers, weren't you?
I was going, was everyone else that finished behind you either blind or have no hands?
There wasn't anyone else behind me.
No, he bribed us to crash. He told us he would buy us a Chinese, and he's never come through with that yet.
Well, takeaway bingo tonight, mate. It's going to happen.
We need to try and find out someone's address that's actually driving a stint at the time and order for them, so that they have to get a knock at the door in the middle of their
stint. No, I've already told someone that I won't answer the door. She said even if I come to the door with me, you and the watts hanging out, you'd still not answer the door if you was driving. I've got no.
Because you've already got your ride for the day.
Well, yeah, that's it. But I'm hoping to get another ride later on, see if I get the engine.
Pull up to my bumper, baby.
I've got to start steering her.
Oh, no. Oh, wow.
I thought Simon was bad.
No, but I haven't seen him. We need to offer this 24 hours of the mum. We need 24 hours of the ring. We want one round here. It's got to be done. It's the daddy of all tracks.
Got
to get working on it.
We'll see. Maybe next year, if our factory's too ready, I know a new version of the model's being made. It was supposed to be Far Factor 1, but the person hasn't
released. Yeah, I know the one you're on about.
Too much about it, so maybe that'll be pushed for Far Factor 2, but yeah, definitely in the future.
What are your guys' views on Far Factor 2, actually? Have either of you two played it?
No, I haven't, only simply because it's still in the beta version. I'm waiting for the full one come out, and then if all the stuff that everyone's having quite a lot to say about is cured, then definitely at the end of the day, it's got to be bought just for the Le Mans series, isn't it?
Well, we have to wait and see what the modding team do and the modding groups do. Hopefully, end races will give us some information soon about their plans, but at the moment I think we'll stick with our Factor 1 because it seems to be working nicely.
Yep.
And it doesn't look like any time soon our Factor 2 will be ready, so...
Well, I'm predicting 2035. There or thereabouts, given ISO's track record.
I suppose then Project Cars will have moved from pre-alpha maybe into beta by 2035, yeah, so these games seem to be getting longer and longer to fully release. I know Live for Speed is still in beta, I believe, even though it's been released for quite a few years.
Right, oh god, yeah.
50.
Well, I recommend everyone to go and buy Snuggle Truck.
Yeah,
because
I watched them.
I've put some stuff as there's David Nichols there. Welcome to the race, David Nichols in fifth position, getting lights flashed by Peter Enders as he's being lapped there. So welcome to the race satellite. That's but yeah, it's flashlight up the bum. It's not good, but
see,
yeah.
And what you're really looking for is like 24 hours of Le Mans with Mario Kart.
oh my god. Yes. Yes, yes, yes. Do you know? Do you know what? I would be like Rock Band with me on the side with all the different instruments going. Ah, here he comes with the mushroom!
Nope. Oh. We've been joined by the other commentator that's normally here but was driving, Roy Magnus for RMI Motorsport. We saw you have an incident, Roy, and get stuck on the curb. What happened?
Well, a couple of laps earlier, 3 or 4 laps earlier, I think I had a spin up in the same section and I touched the wall slightly, so I was continuously losing the right rear end of the car, losing the rear of the car in left-hand corners, and I wasn't fast enough to counter-steer it.
Very bad luck.
So who's taken over you in the car?
Ole Marius is in the car for the next couple of hours, and I'm okay. Probably back into the car again from there on.
Is it just the two of you then?
No, we are three, but...
Just the two of us!
He's doing everything he can to not be behind the wheel.
Yeah.
Oh dear. So, no, welcome. And I'm sure I saw Rene was in here too.
I'm here. Hi guys.
How Hello. You doing, Mr. Hootap?
Well, alias Mr. Asparagus.
Mr. Asparagus. Oh yes.
How are you guys doing?
We're doing much better now, having comedian commentating crackers, chuckle brothers, man with sporran. It's all good. It's all
great,
good.
Great.
Now the fun begins.
It's a bit too professional so far.
How was your stint going, Renault?
Yeah, it went pretty well. It's obvious that in the Ferrari we are having a pretty hard time to face up with the VW Beetles, but hey, we are... but hey, we are still running Ferrari, I believe, so, well, I'm pretty happy with it. After a messy qualifying, we started in, well, I believe 6th or so, and, well, we noticed right away that the cars in front of me were running a higher boost level, and that's why we could drive a couple of laps more, and hopefully it will bring us, well, anything. Well, now Robin is driving after his mishap in Road Atlanta, but, well, he is having a nice rhythm now, so hopefully he will keep it on the track before passing it over to Blom Bailey in 2 hours' time. Well, that's the first car. The second SRVN Ferrari had some troubles with Jeroen Seizou. Well, Jeroen Seizou, you had some troubles pronouncing his name, right?
Yeah, God knows how you say it. It's just bunches of letters.
Yeah, well, just call him Sausage, that's fine.
Yeah, Yuri said you can call him Sausage.
Sausage, yeah,
I don't. I need no encouragement for Sausage, so...
Well, he had a pretty good stint, but had some damage, and then Tiemann Voss, well, alias the boss, took over, but now had a D2 who crashed in front of him, and he had some major damage, and then Giel de Haan took over, and now he's driving a pretty decent stint, so, it's going pretty well, I have to say, but there's a long, long way to go, and you know, you guys know that as well.
Absolutely. Just on your screens, this is Scott Bennett, who I just noticed had lost his front bumper. He's just going past the Schroten brothers, because they've been busy putting their Schrotens up against the barrier at the end of the straights and lost 8 seconds.
It's the one that lost that earlier on.
I tell you, I still think they're driving without it. I think the R4R car.